In this video, I'm going to show you how you can turn your Raspberry Pi into a device that will block online ads across your entire network. All you need for this tutorial really is the Raspberry Pi itself, and let's just get started. So you'll need the Raspberry Pi IP address for this tutorial later on, so let's just get it now, and then we can save a little bit of time later. So what you can either do is, when the Raspberry Pi boots up, if you're not going to use SSH, you can see the IP address on the screen, and if you don't see it, you can just log in and in the terminal just put hostname and then a dash and then the letter I, and then that will show the IP address. But let's say that you can't actually log onto the Pi directly and you're running it headless, then you can still find out the IP with command prompt. So if we just start up the run box by pressing Windows key and R, type in cmd, and then just type in ping raspberry pi dot local. And then this will resolve the Raspberry Pi host name on the network. And as you can see, the IP address for my Raspberry Pi specifically is 192.168.0.171. So we'll remember that for later in the video. But let's just get started by installing Pi-hole onto the Raspberry Pi. So I'm just going to log in to the Raspberry Pi over SSH. You don't have to do this, you can just log in directly, but I just find this more convenient. So here we are on the main terminal screen for the Raspberry Pi, and there's only one command that we actually need to put in to install Pi-hole onto the Raspberry Pi, and that is curl dash lowercase s capital S and then capital L, and then https://install.pi-hole.net /install.pi-hole.net, then space, align, and then bash. But there will be all the commands that you need and everything in the article that is linked below if you just want to copy and paste the commands. So we'll press enter, and as you can see, we have a Pi-hole logo that has appeared on the screen. So just while this is happening, I'm just going to explain a little bit about what Pi-hole is and what it does. So what Pi-hole will do is it will turn your Raspberry Pi into a DNS server. So any device that you point to the Raspberry Pi, such as your router or a specific device such as computers and phones, for DNS queries, it will point them towards the Pi, and then the Pi-hole system will take care of that. And so what's great about this is that Pi-hole, because it's only doing DNS lookups and things like that, and just acting as a DNS server, it won't actually throttle the bandwidth of your internet connection or your LAN connection, since it's just acting as a DNS server. So essentially what that's doing is, when you're browsing to a website, it's obviously taking the URL and performing a DNS lookup on it. So if you go to richtech.net, it's going to try and resolve the IP address that is linked with the domain name. And so when you're on the site and it's loading things such as videos, images, once it gets to an ad and it's trying to resolve the IP address for that, it's going to go to Pi-hole for the lookup on the DNS. And Pi-hole is just going to be like, this is in one of the listed ad servers that's in their record, and it's just going to return nothing, and therefore it's going to block the ad. And what's great about this is that you can do it on any device on your network that's pointing its DNS server towards the Raspberry Pi itself. And then it will just also free up resources on the client, so you won't have to worry about resources being used by ad blocking plugins, because everything's just being handled by the Pi. So as you can see now, it's just going and creating this checklist that you can look as it's installing and configuring things. And by the looks of it, everything's almost done. It hasn't been a super quick process, but obviously it is it's done. So as you can see, we have the IP address info on the screen. It says if you're going to change the IP of the Pi, you need to restart the Pi. And it's also telling you where the admin interface is. So we're going to take a look at the admin interface now. And it's also got the password displayed there, which you can use to log in. And so what we're going to do is obviously go to the Pi-hole login screen. So as you can see, it's got the web interface listed here. So let's just go to http://pi.hole/admin. And that hasn't worked. So if that doesn't work, we're just going to try the alternative, which is http://192.168.0.171/admin. And there we go. That has worked. Here we can see the main PyHole interface. So 24 queries, so total amount of lookups that are happening, blocked queries, and then also domains on the blacklist, which is 123,000, and this is malicious domains, ag domains, stuff like that. So here on the sidebar, you can see we got a lot of different options. So you can whitelist domains so they don't get blocked, and there's also a blacklist so you can block domains. And then you can see you can disable PyHole permanently if you want to, or enable it there. So if you are having issues with stuff, you can disable it for a certain amount of time. Here are some tools to update your lists and block lists and stuff like that. In your main settings, here is a bit of information about the Pi. You can clear settings, restart the Pi itself and stuff like that. So let's just go onto the dashboard and let's change the DNS settings on this computer. So this would be for Windows specifically. And I'm just going to show you what happens when we try to load a website that has ads on it. So let's just go onto change adapter options. Then you're going to need to pick the right network card. So I'm using Ethernet, but if you're using Wi-Fi, pick the right setting. And then I'm just going to go onto properties, and then look for Internet Protocol version 4. And then here, change your DNS settings. So you are probably going to be on automatic settings by default. Just click use the following DNS server addresses. And in here, we're going to put in 192.168.0.171, which is the IP address of the Raspberry Pi. And then as a backup DNS server, in case the Pi is offline or having issues, you can set 8.8.8.8, which is Google's DNS settings. So we'll click OK. And what should happen now is if we go to richtech.net, you can see that there is no ad here. And so if we go back to here, we can actually see, here's my computer's IP address, and you can see the requests which have gone up, queries have been blocked. And so if we refresh this page, we should have a nice graph slowly appearing. And as you can see, here are all the different sites that have been requested, and here are the blocked sites here. But as you can see, that's pretty much it. So ads are being blocked. You can set custom DNS settings on your phone, for example, and add it in, or do it on your router, and that will block it across your entire network. But that's pretty much how to block ads across your entire network with a Raspberry Pi. That's been it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.